So the answer is we need to consider a newer coordinate frame, and we will refer to this as the homogeneous coordinate system. Basically, what we want to do is we want to actually take the two dimensions that we have been looking at before, the xy and the x prime y prime, and a two-dimensional matrix M. Let's start seeing if we can actually represent this as a three vector. So far we've looked at x and y. So we want to be able to take this two-dimensional xy and generate a new three vector. We can basically refer to this as xy and the third vector being 1. And for just sake of completeness and what we will do with it next, let's call this a w. So what we're basically doing is we're adding a third coordinate to every two-dimensional point. So what we did basically is now we're coming up with x, y, w. And the thing we want to remember is what basically w implies is, again, my two-dimensional vector, except that now we are dividing both x and y with the third point here, w. Now, of course, there are certain subtle things we need to pay attention to. Here, for example, is my simple two-dimensional x and y. I can basically look at this point here, 2 and 1. Of course, just looking at x1, y1, the values would be 2, 1. Now, just keeping this convention in mind, if I had omega or w to be 1, this still makes a reasonable sense. 2, 1, 1 applies. But then, of course, imagine I convert w to 2, then 4, 2, 2 applies. And if I make w be 3, 6, 3, 3 applies. So this point now can be represented by this 3 vector in all three of these values. One thing to note, w cannot be 0, because if you make this 0, x and y also would actually go to infinity. So of course, when w is 0, we can refer to that as an infinite point. This point, 0, 0, 0, is not allowed, because we cannot have 0 over 0. That would be an indeterminate point. But all of a sudden, now we have a lot of strength in our hands when we actually now create this new coordinate system, the homogeneous coordinate system, with x, y, and w. Let's see what that buys us.